nullifying that account of whatever you have done in the past. So imagine if the Bhishma Pitama is nullifying his account. Similarly, you must have heard many of the mythological story of this correlation with law of redemption. Then you'll mention that why only I am suffering, or why I am having such people in my life or such circumstances in my life. So there was a mention in the scriptures that God is placing you into a furnace. You are just a piece of metal to convert you into a silver. So the lady, once reading this scripture, didn't understand what actually they want to mention. So she visits a silversmith, where she sees that a silversmith was working with a piece of metal. He just places the metal into the furnace and keep on watching it. So she said, that's it, you are gonna watch it? Yes, he mentions, the silversmith, that if I don't keep a watch on it, it will burn off. So the lady asked further that what is your intention to place that metal into fire? He says that I want to convert that metal into silver, so I have placed it into the furnace. That's when she understand that God, the silversmith, throws we, the metal, into the furnace called life, so that we face different kind of circumstances and difficulties in our life, and not to get burned, but we come out of it forming a glittering silver. So further she curiously asked that when you understand that it is to be taken out from that furnace, that metal piece. So he says that when I see myself in that metal, I take it out. So she further understands it, God, that is we, that is every one of us, is an impression of God, comes to the life, that is to through the furnace of life, and then again evolve into God. So there is nothing called easy life. If it was easy life, then Gandhiji didn't had to face bullets, and Nelson Mandela didn't had to stay in prison for 27 years. Jesus didn't had to face that particular cross. Mahavir Swami didn't had to place nails in his ears. Similarly, our sport person works so hard day and night to get succeeded in that particular race of theirs. Those people and even us are gonna face failure, success, to become champions. There is no such thing called easy life. The life is actually trying you to make what you can actually become. So face what you have to face in life. The epic mentions that once Krishna and Balarama were going through a forest. That was a night time, so they decide to sleep. So Krishna came up with a proposal to Balarama that I am sleeping right now, so whenever you feel sleepy, you wake me up, then I'll watch around and you sleep. So Krishna sleeps off and Balarama walks to and fro. Suddenly he encounters a monster in a bush. So the monster shouted or screams loudly, and Balarama got terrified and he shrunk down. Again the monster screams aloud, and Balarama again got scared, and Balarama shrunk in size and monster expands. The epic mentions that third time the monster screams loudly and the monster expands a lot, and Balarama is shrunken in size because he got scared and terrified. And the last time when the monster screams, the Balarama is so terrified that he shouts loudly, Krishna, and he faints.